Hello and welcome back to Something Z, and welcome to What If Naruto Had the One Tails Part 2. Last time on the What If, Naruto was able to become a genin, and he, Sasuke, and Sakura became Team 7, with their leader being Kakashi. And after a while, they get sent on a mission that they assume was a C rank, and after they get attacked by a couple of shinobi, they find out that the mission was mislabeled, and it was actually higher. But even with this knowledge, they continued with the mission, and eventually, after some time, they come across a shinobi by the name of Zabuza, and he and Kakashi fight, but before the fight could end, he gets killed by a shinobi with a mask. And he gets taken away. Then after the fight, Kakashi was taken to the bridge builder's house to rest. Okay, so now that that's out of the way, let's jump into the video in 3, 2, 1. So we now begin this what if days after the fight between Zabuza and Kakashi, and by this point Kakashi was still knocked out, and when he woke up he found himself in a place he did not recognize. He then tried to get up, but when he tried to move he felt pain throughout his whole body, and when he began to move a woman in the room noticed that he was awake, and she pushed him back down, and she told him that he should rest since he was fatigued, and she told him that his team brought him there, and when she told him that, he calmed down, and he went back to sleep, and a couple of days later Kakashi got up, and he began to move, but since he was still injured and tired, he needed crutches in order to move, and when he got up, he got his three genin and he brought them into the woods. And when they were far enough, he told them that they will be learning to walk up vertical angles. And when the gang did it for the first time, Sasuke and Naruto had trouble doing it. But Sakura was able to walk up a tree completely, without any problem, and the two continued to try to walk up the trees in the forest all day, while Sakura went to the store with the bridge builder. But before she left, she decided to give Naruto some advice, which helped him a bit, since she needed Naruto to be at his best. So now we skip to that night, and Sasuke and Naruto were able to get a decent grasp on walking on vertical angles, but they still haven't completely mastered it. They also learned that night why Inari seemed so closed off. It was because his stepfather died to Gaara, and since then, he doesn't believe that heroes exist. And hearing this, Naruto wanted to make Inari believe that hero still exists. So he ran out of the house and he began to train by walking up the trees again. And he trained until he was out of energy. And when he was out of energy, he finally fell asleep. And while he was dreaming, he was told he was worthless. And he was shown his whole team dead. Then before anything else could happen, he woke up. And when he did, he saw someone right in front of him. And startled by the fact that someone was standing above him, Naruto grabbed minerals from the ground around him. And he gained sand. And he began to surround himself with it. And seeing this, the person in a kimono dropped the plants they were holding. And they pulled out needles, which Naruto recognized from the fight about a week ago. So Naruto asks what was the Mashinobi doing here, and where is Zabuza's body. Then the person in the kimono admits that they were the Mashinobi, and he told Naruto that he needed to stock up on medical herbs since he ran out. And he told Naruto that Zabuza's body was taken to the person who paid him to get rid of him. And since Naruto doesn't have any choice but to believe him, Naruto puts down his sand, and he says he's sorry for rushing to conclusions. And the person in the kimono puts the needle back into their kimono, and he accepts Naruto's apology. Then he tells Naruto that he should continue collecting herbs. So he then left without telling Naruto anything else. And when Haku was outside, Sasuke appeared, and he told Naruto that they should continue training. And by the end of the day, the two were able to completely walk up their trees. So now we skip to the next day, and Sasuke, Sakura, and Kakashi took Tazuna to his bridge. And they didn't bring Naruto since he was tired from using so much chakra, and his body finally collapsed. And when he woke up, he was a couple of hours behind the rest of his team. So Naruto then got ready, and he ran to the bridge as fast as he could. But before he was able to get to the bridge, Naruto ran back. Since on his way to the bridge, he saw cut marks leading back to Tazuna in this house. So now we jump to the bridge, and Team 7 was just watching the bridge builder work, making sure he doesn't get harmed. Then the four noticed Zabuza and the Mashinobi standing on the water, and before they could do anything, Zabuza covered the area in a thick mist, and Zabuza and Kakashi began to fight, while Sasuke went to fight Haku, and Sakura was holding a kunai, protecting Tazuna, and after a couple of minutes, Sasuke gets surrounded by ice mirrors. So now we jump back to Naruto, and he just got back to Tazuna's house, and the first thing he saw was Inari running at two thugs, and his mom was held hostage behind them. So Naruto quickly ran in front of Inari, and he used the sand from his container to create a wall between the thugs and Inari. Then he told Inari that he could handle this. Then he created three shadow clones, which attacked the thugs, and after a couple of minutes, the thugs go to attack the mother, since they wanted to at least do something to hurt Tazuna. But before they could attack her with a sword, Naruto was able to move the sand and create a wall in front of her, stopping the attack. Then before the thugs could react, Naruto reformed the sand wall into shurikens, and he flung them at the thugs, and they get hit in the limbs. Then Naruto used some nearby rope to tie the two up, and when everything was taken care of, Naruto began to run to the bridge again. And when he got there, he saw Zabuza and Kakashi fighting, and Sakura was standing by the bridge builder to protect him. He also saw Sasuke surrounded by ice mirrors, and thinking that the other two could handle themselves, Naruto ran to Sasuke, and he tried to attack the mirror from the outside. But when he saw that that wasn't work, he jumped in the mirror dome, and he surrounded himself and Sasuke with his sand, and he made them a cocoon, which protected them from the ice needles that the mirrors were throwing. And after a while, Naruto could tell that no more ice needles were being thrown, so he opened up the cocoon a bit, and what he saw was the ice mirrors around them were gone. But now it was so Tazuna and Sakura were trying their their best to avoid the needles. So he and Sasuke ran out of the cocoon and they ran to their aid. And again, Naruto created a cocoon around them. But this time, Zabuza saw them and he backs away from Kakashi. And with the time he had, he was able to create a clone of himself, which ran to the cocoon while the real Zabuza continued the fight with Kakashi. And Kakashi wasn't able to help to get Tazuna since Zabuza didn't give him any time to back up. So now we jump back to the group. And while in the cocoon, they were trying to come up with a plan to get out. But before they were able to, they hear Zabuza telling them to let the bridge builder out, and he'll spare their lives. And when they don't respond, Zabuza began to slash at the cocoon. And when that didn't work, he told Haku to get back. Then when Haku was practically off the bridge, Zabuza began to do the hand signs. Tiger, ox, monkey, rabbit, ram, boar, ox, horse, monkey, tiger, dog, tiger, snake, tiger, ox, monkey, rabbit, bird. Then he shouted water style, giant waterfall. Then the water around the bridge shot up, and it got launched at the cocoon, which was able to hold itself together for a second. But after a couple of seconds, the sand lost its durability, and it began to separate. So Naruto shouted for them to hold their breath. And right after he said that, a hole opened in the cocoon, and it got filled with water. Then the hole opened until there was no cocoon. And when Naruto was able to open his eyes, he saw Tazuna, Sasuke, and Sakura on the ground. And when he looked around, he saw that they were just about at the edge of the bridge. And the two enemy shinobi were walking closer to them. So Naruto picked himself up, and he grabbed the sand he could. But sadly, a lot of the sand blew away in the attack. And when it got up, shortly afterward, his two teammates picked themselves up, and they were ready to fight. So Sasuke used a fireball jutsu, but the two were able to dodge the attack. And Sakura ran to Tazuna to protect him. And Naruto used his remaining sand to create kunais, and he flung them at the water clone. And the clone was able to dodge most of them, but it got hit in its right leg. So the water clone and Naruto began to fight, while Sasuke focused on Haku. But after a while, Haku created another ice dome around Sasuke. And after a couple of minutes, he starts to run out chakra, and he eventually passes out. And since the group was close enough, all of them besides Kakashi saw Sasuke fall to the ground. And since he was covered in blood, they suspected he fell because of his wounds. And when Sakura saw this, she began to cry. But she tried to keep herself together, or she would die as well. But Naruto took it harder, since he lost a comrade, someone who treated him somewhat like an equal. But what makes it hurt even more is the fact that he knew that Haku was there, so he could have stopped this from even happening. Then Naruto starts to unconsciously use the One Tail's chakra. And seeing this as a way to escape, the One Tail tries to take control. So Naruto starts to get covered with sand on his right side. So now he has a monster's hand made out of sand, and the right side of his face became a bit more chubbier. He also has an animal ear, and his once blue eye is now black with a yellow pupil. And Kakashi was able to tell what was going on, since he could feel a massive surge of chakra, and he saw sand appear around them, then shoot out to one point. So he knew he had to fight as quick as he could. And when Naruto was done transforming, Naruto began to grow a huge smile. Then he ran at the Zabuza water clone, and he used the sand he had for his arm to create sand shurikens. And this time, he was able to land the shurikens just enough so the clone turned back to water. Then Naruto turned his head to the ice mirror dome, and when he did, he made eye contact with Haku, which made Haku freak out, so he tried to escape by jumping from ice mirror to mirror. And when Naruto saw this, he ran at Haku as fast as he could, and he was able to punch Haku while he was out of a mirror. And when he punched Haku, Haku got flung through an ice mirror, which shattered. And when the mirror broke, all the mirrors shattered at once. And when Haku landed, he landed on his back, and he tried to get up and run. But before he could even turn, Naruto was able to hit Haku in the leg with more sand shurikens, which slowed him down for a couple of seconds. And Naruto was able to reach Haku in time. And when he got to Haku, he punched him in the face. And this time, it made Haku fall to the ground, and his mask cracked, and it showed his face. But since Naruto saw it already, he wasn't surprised. So Naruto just kept attacking him, punching him again and again. And eventually, Naruto was able to kill Haku. And when Tazuna and Sakura saw that Naruto killed Haku, they were stunned. And Sakura even raised her kunai in case Naruto went to attack them. And since Haku was dead, he wasn't able to protect Zabuza from the Chidori from Kakashi. So when Kakashi went for the Chidori, he was able to hit Zabuza in the chest, and that was able to kill him, so both of the enemy shinobi were dead. And since Zabuza was dead, the mist he created was now gone. Then Kakashi ran to Naruto as fast as he could, since he needed to get Naruto under control, and he began to fight against Naruto. And again, he was able to look Naruto in the eyes, and he put Naruto under a genjutsu. But this time, he made Naruto go into a calm genjutsu to make him calm down and revert back to normal. And while Naruto was reverting back to normal, Kakashi bit his finger and he wrote on Naruto where his original seal was. And after a couple of minutes, the writing formed into another seal on Naruto. And when the seal was finished, Naruto passed out. Then the group goes to check on Sasuke since he passed out. But before they were able to check thoroughly, a group of people start to walk onto the bridge. And the person in the front was a short guy in a suit, and he tells them that they actually helped him, since they were going to do the same thing. Then he tells his goons to attack the group, so the goons began to run at Kakashi. And Kakashi tells Sakura to take care of the fallen and Tazuna. Then Kakashi ran at the group and he began to fight them, and he used his Sharingan to avoid any attacks, and after a couple of minutes, Kakashi was able to defeat around half of the goons. But before anything else could happen, more people start to appear on the bridge, and at the front of that group there was Inari, and he was leading the villagers from the town, and the two groups began to fight. And since the villagers had more people, and they had the aid of Kakashi, they were able to beat the thugs, and they were able to surround Gaara, who pleased to them, saying he couldn't pay them anything. But the villagers were not having it, so they tied Gaara up in a rope, and they took him away so he could face his punishment. And they took the goons to face the same punishment. And a couple of minutes after the fight, Sasuke woke up, since he was able to get just enough chakra to wake up. And they briefed him about what just happened. And while they were talking, Sakura asked Kakashi if they could still trust Naruto, since what if he loses control again, and they aren't able to control him? And Kakashi tells her that even if he can't be controlled completely, he is still a person, and he is your teammate, since he only became like that when he believes that Sasuke died. And hearing that, Sakura calmed down a bit. So now we skip a couple of days, and when everyone was healed up enough, Team 7 left. Since the person that was after Tazuna was captured, they weren't needed. So now we skip about a week, and after the mission, the third Hokage got all the team leaders, and he told them about the upcoming exam. And he asked what Kakashi, Asuma, and Kurenai think about their getting. And they tell the third Hokage that they believe they are capable enough. And while this was going on, the same things happened with Team 7 and Konohamaru. So Konohamaru is currently being held up by his collar by a foreign shinobi. And saying this, Naruto ran at the shinobi, but before he was able to make it to the two, he tripped. But before anything else could happen, a red-haired person tells his teammate to put the kid down. And after some persuading, the person holding Konohamaru puts him down. Then the red-haired person apologized for his teammate's rudeness. Then the two walk away. So now we skip to the next morning, and Kakashi assembled Team 7. And it's there that they learn about the Chunin exams, and Sasuke and Naruto were on board. But Sakura, however, felt hesitant about taking the exams. But after some convincing, she decided to take the exams as well. Then the meeting ended, but right before they left, Kakashi told them that the test will be in about a week. Then the three began to leave. But before Naruto left, Kakashi stopped him, and he told him that they have something they need to discuss. Then Kakashi told Naruto about the seal that he placed on him, and how it will prevent the Shukaku from taking control. But if it actually does, it will be useless, and he could be on a rampage until someone stops him. And hearing this, Naruto nodded, then he left. So now we skip about a week, and the training Naruto did was training his sand techniques and his taijutsu with the help of his shadow clones. And during that week, he was able to learn two different jutsus, Sand Armor, which increases his defense, and Eye of Sand, so he makes an eyeball made out of sand, which he can also see through. But since he just learned it, he can only create one at a time. So now Team 7 just got to where the exam should take place. But when they got there, the hallway was full of examinees wanting to be let in, and standing in the doorway was two shinobi, not allowing anyone in. And after a minute of Team 7 waiting for something to happen, a fight starts to happen between an examinee and one of the people in the doorway. But before it became an actual fight, a guy with a bowl cut and a green jumpsuit stood in between the two, thus stopping the fight. Then the guy in the jumpsuit locks eyes with Sasuke. Then he challenges him to a fight, which at first Sasuke declined. So Naruto instead challenged the guy in the jumpsuit, which he accepted. So Team 7 and the guy walked to an arena not that far away. But right after they left, they pointed out that the room they were at was not the actual exam room, and it was actually a fake. Then when the rest of the examinees figured this out, they all ran to the actual exam room. So after a couple of minutes, Naruto and Rock Lee were face to face, and when Sakura was done counting, the fight began. And when it did, Rock Lee ran at Naruto, and he tried to punch Naruto in the gut. But before the attack hit, sand came out of Naruto's container, and it created a shield, which blocked the punch. Then Lee began to barrage Naruto with a mixture of punches and kicks, and eventually after a couple of minutes, Lee was able to punch Naruto where there wasn't sand, so he was able to punch Naruto in the gut. And when he got punched, Naruto fell to the ground. But after a couple of seconds, Naruto made around 4 shadow clones, which get destroyed easily by Lee. And after a couple of minutes, Naruto says that they should stop, since they shouldn't go all out before the exams. And Lee agrees, and he was about to walk away. But before he got too far, Sasuke accepts Lee's earlier challenge, but he was easily defeated by Lee, even with the help of his Sharingan. But before Lee could deliver the final blow, a puff of smoke appeared out of nowhere, and in that smoke appears a turtle, which, to Team 7's surprise, makes Lee stop in his tracks. And when he lands, he runs to the turtle and he says he's sorry. But just then, another puff of smoke appeared on top of the turtle, and in that smoke appears a person that looks like a more grown-up version of Lee, who then, in a matter of less than a minute, punches Lee for using a forbidden technique. And hugging and crying with him. Seeing this, Team 7 tried to leave, but before they could leave the room, the guy knows them, and he asks how is his rival doing. It's then that the Genin learn about how Gai and Kakashi are rivals. Then after they talk for a bit, the two leave. Then the three go to the exam hall, so now we skip to the actual exam, and everything we skip is just about the same. So now all the Genin taking the exams were in a room filled with desks, and they were placed so they couldn't sit with their teammates. And when everyone was sitting down, the main instructor gets out of his seat and stands in front of the room, and he tells everyone the rules of the exam. And when he was done explaining the rules, the examiner gave all the examinees the test. And Naruto started the test by looking to see who knew the answers. And after a minute, Naruto Naruto was able to find an examinee who seemed to know all the questions, so he waited till he believed that he got most of them down, and he manipulated his sand, and he put a couple grains into that examinee's eyes. And he made his third eye right next to the paper, and he copied the answers as fast as he could, and when he was done, he removed the eye of sand, and he acted like he was deep inside. So when it's time, the main examiner stands at the front of the room, and he tells everyone that there was actually a tense question. But before he says what the question is, he says that whoever fails this question will be permanently banned from taking the exams, and if one person gets it wrong, the whole team fails. Then the whole team fails. But there is a way out. If you don't want to take the question, you and your team will have to fail this exam, but you can return next year. And after around a minute, the people that wanted to leave left. And when the main examiner believed that they all left, he says it's time for the final question. But instead of saying the question, he just said that they all passed. Since the question was, would they still try, even if they could fail forever? So now Team 7 has made it to the second phase of the exam. And this is where I'm going to leave the what if. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope to see you next time on Something Z.